Can copper peptides regrow hair? If you're like me, you've been seeing advertisements for copper peptides all over the place, so I decided to get curious and look at the research for myself. Oh, and by the way, I don't work for any copper peptide company, dietary supplement company, or pharmaceutical company either. So if you're researching this for yourself, the first thing you're going to run into are the letters GHK. GHK is a peptide, sometimes called a tripeptide because it's made of three different amino acids. They are glycine, histidine, and lysine. Now, GHK is a naturally occurring peptide. It's found in the plasma. We've known about it since the 1970s. And one of the things that GHK likes to do is bind to copper. And when it does this, it's usually written in the literature as GHK-CU, where CU stands for copper. So in other words, if you're researching this for yourself and you see the letters GHK-CU, that's copper peptides. So GHK is naturally found in collagen, and when we're injured, GHK gets released into the system. This is another reason why people suggest that GHK may even play a role in wound healing too. So if you're researching this for yourself, one of the things you're quickly going to come across is the statement that when we're younger, we make a lot of GHK. However, by the time we reach our 60s, that level has dropped by over 50%. So the idea here is if you could just replenish your GHK levels, things would improve to that of when you were younger. Now, in terms of copper, it's a trace nutrient. And while most people are probably not deficient in copper, it does take part in some very impressive things, such as the production of collagen and elastin. And copper also helps us make a very powerful antioxidant compound called superoxide dismutase. So what's the evidence that copper peptides can regrow hair on the scalps of human beings? Well, one of the first studies I located was this one from the 1990s, finding that copper peptides could stimulate hair follicles in mice. The only study that I was able to find on this topic was this paper where they took a bunch of different growth factors, including copper peptides, and injected them into the scalps of people. And they do show some very interesting before and after pictures in this study, such as this picture here, where you do see significant hair growth. However, remember, these compounds were injected, and even if they weren't, this study can't prove that topically applied copper peptides by themselves regrow hair. I was unable to locate any human clinical trials of topically applied copper peptides showing that it actually regrew hair on the heads of human beings. And you know what? Nobody else making YouTube videos that promote copper peptides are showing any proof either. Many of them don't even list their references in their videos. All my references are below in the description so you can see them for yourself. Now, the weird thing here is that this would be easy to test. Just get a bunch of people who are losing their hair. Some of them give copper peptides. Some of them get a placebo. You follow them for 6 months and take before and after pictures. Easy peasy. So why hasn't anybody done studies like that? And while we're on the topic, I don't see any evidence that copper peptides regrow hair any better than other natural things, like for instance, pumpkin seeds. And to learn more about pumpkin seeds, see my video below to see the before and after pictures of when people took that. Now, it is true that lack of evidence does not mean copper peptides don't work. It just means we need more research. And until that research is done, I see no evidence that you have to spend a lot of money on copper peptide hair growth serums. And when that research comes out, I will do a video on it. But until that time, you tell me, did copper peptides regrow your hair?